That's where it came from. Okay. I got a joke for you. What article of clothing does God love the most? I'm going to give you some time to think about it. I'm going to give you some time. The answer is simple. And I know because y'all feel like it's a sneaker channel. It has to be shoes. But do you know why, though? Because it has a soul. Get it? Like the soul of a shoe. Intro. Yeah.
Mind on Yahweh, anything else don't digest right. Sneaker head, the kicks got kicks. You don't want no smoke if you laying out Christ. Icon, that's her in a nutshell. Focused on Christ and it goes well. That's why they still pulling on the coattail.
First off, before we get started, I just want to make y'all aware of this. Let me scoot up so that way you can understand. There's nothing wrong with me, okay? I understand that y'all see this on the phone. I had to go to the doctor because when you go to the doctor on a normal basis, then it prevents you from having any major ailments and illnesses from coming upon you later on down the line. Now, that's a really good lesson, and I won't preach that today. So I just want you to look at your neighbor. Don't touch them because we're still supposed to be socially distanced. But I want you to touch your neighbor and say this. When you check up often, you don't have to catch up later. You're welcome. All right, let's get back to the normal video. Welcome back, y'all. I'm so glad to see y'all here. This month is considered National Women's History Month. And so, of course, y'all already know what I had to do. I had to highlight a sneaker that has to do with a woman. I thought that would be perfect to do. Not only that, but March 8th is considered International Women's Day. And that is a day where we celebrate the social, economic, and political achievements of women all around the world. I just want to jump right on in and get straight into the sneaker for today because it is super dope and I'm excited about it. Y'all can already see it. Oh man. Anywho, here we go. It is the Maya Moore Jordan 10 Court Lux. Court Lux. Look at that. Get a good look. Let me move that over there to the side so y'all can see this. That's important. I'm gonna go over that in a little bit. I wear my shoes, so oh Lord. This is the shoe, the Jordan 10, the Maya Moore Jordan 10s. Now she had another shoe and I probably put that over there somewhere, but for now, this is the one. It comes with, what's this, black shoelaces. And I decided to put the baby blue ones in here because, I mean, it's super dope. And so you see the new buck suede. It has the cobalt blue or royal blue, little hint of purple here, like an eggplant purple, and then the orange. I call it UT orange. On the shoe though, it's called Concord Black Rush Red. It don't even mention anything else, but it is what it is. It has the translucent sole at the bottom. I wear my shoes. I have to tell y'all that because sometimes some people be tripping about it. It released on December 22nd, 2018. It retailed at $190. And then it has her favorite scripture embroidered on the back. So you already know what we're doing today. We're doing that scripture because that's it. And this is said to be, she picked the 10, or they picked the 10, because this the 10 is said to be Maya Moore's favorite Jordan. So when she teamed up with them, she chose the 10. And it released with the AM Jordan 1s. I put a picture of those over there. I'm trying to get them because I really, really like those shoes. So if anybody's trying to, you know, celebrate me for International Women's Month, it's National Women's History Month. You're more than welcome to give me the AM Jordan 1s that I put over there. I'm not trying to. I just want you to know. It's called a quartet color block because there's four different colors. And because of the makeup of the shoe. This shoe, the 10s, are actually some of my most comfortable Jordans to me out of all the 10s. And I like the colorway. I like how she did block off the colors. I thought the color scheme was amazing. What I love most about these is that it's really hard to find something to go with it, but I think that's what makes them so dope. I would wear it with this, even though, shout out to Erykah Badu, Ireland, that I really, 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 really like this shoe. Maya Moore has a whole bunch of achievements. She's a two-time NCAA champion, a four-time WNBA champion, three-time WCBA champion, six-time WNBA All-Star. She's an Olympic gold medalist. In 2012, she's won more games than any player in college basketball history. She won at least 90 games. She was the number one draft pick by the Minnesota Lynx in 2011. She was the first woman to be signed to Jordan Brand. So she made history right there. But she stepped away for love in 2019. She stepped away from basketball for love. She decided to put down the basketball and pick up the law. And on July 1st, 2020, she managed to free the love of her life, Jonathan Irons, who was wrongfully convicted by an all-white jury and was set to serve a 50-year sentence. She had a huge hand in getting him or setting him free, and they got married. I think that's the cool and cute part about this, man. Like, she put down something that she was clearly good at. It's not like she just tried it and was like, you know, if I get it, I get it. If I don't, I don't. No, like, she was amazing, and she was already setting records before she came to the WNBA. Jordan's even signed off on her because she's cold, y'all. Like, we don't know if she's gonna come back. Hopefully she does, is what I'm hoping, you know. But if not, man, her historical resume is already solidified. So shout out to Maya Moore, man. Again, her favorite scripture is embroidered on the back. This says 3:23. Her favorite scripture is Colossians 3:23. I'm just gonna jump right into it. You know why I'm here? I'm here because I want to spread the gospel. And the best way to spread this gospel is to give it to you the way that the Lord gave it to me. Colossians 3:23. And it says this: whatever you do, work heartily as for the Lord and not for men. Whatever you do, work heartily as for the Lord and not for men. First off, let me just say that it is huge that she even was able to get a scripture embroidered on her shoe, because speaking from what I know about Nike, they're not really big on, you know, they're big on, you know, making sure that race, creed, and color and all of that is in place, but not when it comes to religion. How do we know this? Because I believe that's the reason that Steph Curry decided to go with Under Armour, because he was given full autonomy or full power or the green light to be able to put his favorite scripture on his shoe. So I think it's very interesting that she was able to get this scripture on her shoe. I think it's amazing, but even more so, that scripture from Colossians 3:23, simply put, all that scripture is saying is that only what you do for Christ is going to last, right? We spend so much of our lives and so much of our time trying to do things because we want to leave a legacy, because we don't want to be forgotten. We want people to remember us. It's people that are alive right now that's already doing things because they envision their own funeral and they want people to remember them this way. And if they die, I want people to be able to say this. But very seldom do you hear people that say, I'm really and truly living this life because I'm doing it for God. Not because of man, but for God. Now, what are you saying, Adria? I'm not saying that there's anything wrong with wanting to make sure that once you're out of here, that people have great things to say and that people think great things about you. I don't think that there's anything wrong in and of itself with doing things out of the goodness of your heart because you love people. I love people, but even more, a lot of the things that I do it even more because I love God. God is so good. I'll put it this way. If it weren't for God, I wouldn't even have this channel. If it weren't for God, I wouldn't even be able to do what I'm doing right now. If it weren't for God, there's no way in the world I could have thought up this thought or this dream of taking scripture and sneakers and putting them together to spread this gospel. if it weren't for God, I wouldn't be able to spread this gospel because there wouldn't be any gospel to spread, right? So that's why it's important. And why would there not be any gospel to spread? Because Jesus is the good news. I wouldn't be able to enter into the courts, and I wouldn't be able to enter into the gates with thanksgiving or praise. Why? Because there wouldn't be any reason to, because I probably would have sinned so bad that, I don't know, had it not been for an advocate named Jesus, I wouldn't be able to deliver this to you right now, because I'm pretty sure I probably would have been long gone a long time ago. But because we serve an amazing and awesome God, the Lord, who is the Christ, Jesus, that is, not just any God, because I want you to know, I'm very emphatic about what God I'm talking about. I'm talking about Jesus, the only one, the only wise God I know. I'm talking about Jesus. And if it weren't for him, I wouldn't be here. Maya Moore wouldn't be here. You wouldn't be here. Here's the reality. There's this hymn, and there's a certain line in it that I think is amazing. And I had to really, really lean on it during a pretty tough time. And it talks about how my hope is built on nothing less. What is it built on? Jesus Christ, the solid rock. Why? Because all other ground is sinking sand. That goes right back to our scripture for today, from Colossians 3 and 23. If you work heartily for the Lord and not for men, it's the only thing that's going to last. God is the only constant that you'll ever know. How do I know this? Well, life happens. And when life happens, sometimes life catches you off guard. Sometimes there are some things that you just cannot prepare for. And had it not been for God, then you wouldn't be able to make it to where you are today. Some of us don't look like what we've been through. And because of that, you missed your time to shout. I'm just saying, because I know for me, out of all the stuff that I have going on, had it not been for Jesus, man, I'm telling you, I wouldn't have this hope that I have right now. I wouldn't have the time to do the things I'm doing right now. I wouldn't even feel like doing this right now because I would be so weighed down with the cares of this world. But thanks be to God that we have Jesus. God sent his only son. Scripture. For God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten son. I'm talking about Jesus, man. And there's a reason why I keep repeating his name, because you need to know that there's power in that name. There's hope in that name. There's victory in that name. And we'll talk about victory in later on this month, but I just want you all to be able to fully understand and to grasp this concept that, yeah, man, cars, money, clothes, kicks, it's good, man. Like it's all great. It's all gravy until life hits you, right? It's all gravy until a pandemic hits you. Right? It's all gravy until you don't have no money in the bank. It's all gravy until you got to figure out where you're going to get your next meal from. But all of this stuff can go. What then? What is that sure, emphatic thing that's going to keep you when all of those things that you thought made you happy, all of those things that you thought completed you, is no longer there? What happens if it gets stolen? What happens if the car, if something happens to it? What happens again when a pandemic hits? At what point, what then are you going to have to be able to lean on and to lean into when things get tough and when life just seems unbearable, or when you're laying in bed at night and your mind is going a million miles per hour, or when your emotions fail you, or when your words fail you because you don't know what to say because you know that you have this deep, dark, sad feeling, but you don't have any words to put to it? What are you going to lean on then? It won't be shoes. It won't be cars. It won't be popularity. You won't even care about your followers, because I'm going to tell you something. Most, if not all of your followers ain't going to check on you. But I know a man that will. It was fully human and fully God. I'm in the book being the Bible. And so because he was fully human, he understands what it is that you're going through. Our Bible tells us that we do not serve a God that's untouchable. We don't serve a God whose arms are too short that he can't reach to us right where we are. I understand that you're feeling what you're feeling. Understand that you got going what you got going. And I also understand that the devil be deviling. Yes, it's a real thing. But here's the thing. Scripture tells us to take heart because he has overcome the world. Who is he? Jesus. Because that name makes demons tremble. Woo! That name makes a way out of no way. That name is the name that I call on when I feel like everything else has failed me. There's only one name, and that's Jesus. That's all I got. I'm gonna see y'all in 2 weeks. And until then, man, go be great. Good God, good shoes. I'm signing off. Bye, y'all.